Hello, friends. Welcome in. How are you today? I hope you're having a fantastic start of your day. Well, I say start. It's probably late for a lot of you. I hope, no matter what time it is, it's a good time.
Ultra.
Wait, why didn't I?
Missile hyper jet.
Oh, I can't hear it. Hold on. I muted it for myself. I was like, I thought I fixed all this. All right, hold on. I think we're good.
See you, Space Cowboy.
Go ahead let's move on over. Hello, everybody. N1, Angelic, thank you so much for the lurk, but thank you so much for the 10 months. I very much appreciate it. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you very much. I hope you have a wonderful day. But Emmers, welcome in. You are first. How are you? Lowering the music. How are you? Hope you're having a good day. The 90 stream streak. Incredible. I guess really like 190. Sassy, welcome in. How are you? How's it going? How's your day? We jamming. Gilmore, hello. It's almost 6 where you are. It is almost 4 here. We are starting quite late. But I had a work thing today. I really wasn't sure if I was going to stream. But then, you know, I asked in the Discord if you guys would be interested in at all. And it seems like you guys said yes. So that's why we're here. I don't know how long the stream will be. I don't know how long people will be around. So we'll just kind of play it by ear and whatever. But I was going to say, Emmers, I think you'll be happy for me. Because guess what I had for lunch today? So while I was doing work stuff, on my way back, I was like, there is a place nearby that I have ordered from before. I've ordered it like delivery, but I was like, I've never actually been inside and like eaten there. Sushi? It was in fact sushi. so I was right next to a sushi place that I've ordered food from before, and I really love one of their rolls. And for some reason my Discord did not go into a streamer mode. Hold on. There we go. But I was like, well, I mean, I am a little hungry. I haven't eaten today, and I was like, I'm not sure if I'm streaming, so let me go ahead and I'll just get a roll. So I had one roll and I asked for just a side of rice. Interestingly, I think their menu is actually more expensive if you're there. I think maybe they shave a couple of dollars off, which is kind of the opposite. I feel like most, like if you're ordering from DoorDash and stuff, it's usually like a dollar or two more expensive than if you were to get in the restaurant. I feel like their prices on the app are cheaper by like a dollar or two, but maybe they try to balance it out by like, because they know you're going to be paying for additional fees. So maybe they're like trying to make it more reasonable. Silver Shadow, welcome in. How are you? I got you for 3 minutes. Brad, welcome in. I thought it was funny. I was like, oh, we actually have quite a few no's. I was like, wait, Brad voted twice. Incredible. Yimit said no. I don't know what Yimit's doing or why he doesn't want me to stream, but, you know, I almost didn't because I was like, well, if Yimit doesn't want me to stream. So I got a deep fried sushi roll and it was delicious. It's already good. Like, again, I've had it before when they deliver it, but I've never had it like just fresh, like right after it's been made. Wow. It was so good. it already tastes great, but it was like just delicious. And so I just had a side of rice because everything else was kind of expensive. I really wanted some gyoza, but I was like, that's another like $8 for like 6 gyoza. That seems like a lot. I've gotten before from them like some chicken fried rice, and that's good. I also saw that they sell ramen. I didn't know that. But their ramen was like $20 or something. I was like, yeesh. The other ramen place that I really like, I think each bowl is like 16, so that's much more doable. But anyway, I mean, it's like 14 or something like that. It's considerably more expensive at this other place. But anyway, the sushi roll is so good. I can't remember what is in it, but it's like kind of spicy, but not too spicy. But it's deep fried, and they put bonito flakes on top of it, so it has like a crunch to it. It's gimme. It's so good. We had our food order canceled today, so we actually had to cook. What happened? Why did they cancel it, Sassy? What have you been up to, Shadow? Might be because of his hockey game. Maybe that's what it was. I just thought it was funny. I was like, it is. I mean, like, if you guys are like, I won't be able to make it, feel free to say no. But it was just funny. I was like, oh, dang, we actually have quite a few no's. No idea. They canceled and refunded us. Oh, wow. I've never had an order just randomly canceled, but I definitely, I've had someone like steal an order before. Like they went and picked it up and then they just like left. I think I had to cancel it because then like something then happened. Like, they tried to remake it, but then something happened, and then it just never got picked up. And so then, like, I think I was just like, okay, well, I guess I'll do something else. Do you see the screenshot I tagged you in on Talents? I did not. I can go look. Oh, that's funny. Actually, you know, Too Much to Bear in our community sent us a screenshot of this person too. I think I said this person looks unwell. I think it's the paint around the eyes. but that's very funny. Yeah. I've seen the preset. Did y'all see they're making a live action How to Train Your Dragon? I did see that. How do you guys feel about it? Too Much to Bear, speaking of, welcome in. How are you? What do you guys feel about it? Do we need a live action of that movie? Will it be good? What do you guys think? Will Craig Ferguson reprise his role? He should. He's probably too old now. I don't like it because How to Train Your Dragon is my favorite animated movie. I feel like not every animated movie needs a live action, you know? And it really feels like right now Hollywood is like, we gotta do everything we can. Here, I'm holding thoughts until I see more than just a 30-second scene. Yeah, Toothless did look really cute though. I've heard the reaction to Toothless has been good. I've only seen it once, so I don't have like a full buy-in to it. So like, I don't know if I'll see it at all, but like, I liked the original movie. I think they should be doing the opposite. Instead of making animated movies into live action movies, I think they need to be doing live action movies into animated. So like, give me like a Pixar's Godfather. Like that would be great. Like, they need to take some of these older movies that, like, probably a lot of, like, people might be hesitant to watch because they're like, but it's so old. Like, the cinematography or, like, whatever, it's just so outdated. They should animate some of those. Dez, welcome in. How are you? Pixar, oh gosh, you know how good that would be? A Pixar Lord of the Rings? Oh my goodness, that would be incredible. That would be so good. Or like maybe not Pixar, but like an animated Lord of the Rings. Like,
catch you on the flippy flip.
Current CG stuff, that'd be excellent. Brad, thank you so much for the lurk. I hope you have a wonderful stream. Why are you picking fights with me? I try, but I hurt my back. I feel like I could win a lot of fights. Mostly because I have nothing left to lose, you know? What I have been up to is we have been decluttering and packing as we are selling our house and moving interstate. Oh, wow. Wow, wow, wow. Well, I hope that goes well. When is the move? Like the War of oh, that's true. Yeah, they're making like an anime. That looks like it's going to be epic. Yeah, I'll be excited for that. But like, even if it's just like, you know, the trilogy, I would love to see that in... There's probably a lot they could really do to make it look very cool. There'd be some great scenes. I feel like the fight scenes could be really, really well done. They could also do some of the stuff that, like, maybe they left out of the trilogy. Like, I don't know. I think that would just be so cool. I like that idea too much to bear. Send that to Peter Jackson. As soon as the house sells, I hope it sells well. I've heard it's a buyer's market or something. Maybe it's a seller's market because a lot of people are buying. I think that's what I mean. So it seems like there's a lot of people in the market to buy a house, so I hope it happens fast for you. How far away are you moving? It's a seller's market. That's what I mean. Yeah. Seller's market. So. Stuff is super expensive. Yeah, it seems to be that way everywhere. I'm in the Brisbane subreddit, and so I get a lot of Brisbane news. And leave me alone. And I hear a lot of people talking about housing there and being like either really hard to find a place or like it's really expensive or whatever. That was exactly what I was thinking of, Sassy. Tom Bombadil. I was like, that could be something that, like, they could add and stuff. That could be fun. By the way, Daz, how are you? How's your day? I'm starting much later today. So I don't know if you're, like, you're probably up by now. They talk about him in the narration of the Fellowship. Yeah. So, like, I feel like there's some cool stuff they could do if they made that. So I say we need to start doing the opposite. Instead of making animated movies into live action movies animated. That is my vote. Plodding along, sorting out Amazon stuff. Are you like ordering some stuff? Midday here, about to go for lunch, but still working out why. You picking fights with I don't know. Sometimes you feel like fighting. I don't know. Left him out because they felt like he didn't really have an impact. Yeah, that's a good point. You know, like in the overall story, it's, you know. Ordered some things. Nice. We are in Brisbane, near where Talonis lives, and we are moving to a country town called Shepparton in Victoria. Oh, nice. Oh, so you're moving. Oh, so you're also moving states. Interesting. I bet. Is that going to be a long drive? That's a change. Yeah, I bet. Shepparton. I've never heard of Shepparton. How close is that to, like, Melbourne? Right? Melbourne is in Victoria, if I recall. What was I gonna say? There was something. Ben. Melbourne. I didn't say Melbourne, did I? No. Melbourne. That's how you guys say it. I'm saying it like you do. I'm one of you. I should? No, I've been told I need to say it correctly. Wait. Ben? Wait. Who's Mel? I mean, you guys say Melbourne. Isn't that how you guys say it? Am I emphasizing too much of the I? The N? Is there too much N in that? Des, now we're fighting. Des wanted a reason to fight. Now we're fighting. We are going to fly to Melbourne. Melbourne. Is it more of an un? Wait. Oh my gosh, Daz. I swear you're calling the city a bin. Or he's getting gas. No, because a lot of Americans say Melbourne. But a lot of Aussies say Melbourne. Am I saying too much bin? Is there too much bin in there? Is it more of like a bun? Melbourne? This will be on the test for Aussie citizenship. It probably will be. I think there's too much bin in it. Okay, so too much bin. Too much bin. Dial back the bin. Bun is bin. Melbourne. 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 I'll just start mumbling it. Melbourne. maybe that'll help. I thought Melbourne. I guess I got too comfortable. Melbourne. That's... Aussies are fantastic mumblers. Yeah, I'll definitely start mumbling more. Side note, if I get deported, can I, like, seek refuge in Australia? Is that allowed? How would that happen? What would... Thank you. What would happen there? Sure. Okay. I'm going to take your word for it as legal advice. Just fill out the paper. Are you trying to... No, I'm not trying to get deported, but I mean, I might with all the stuff that's happening. So we'll see. We'll very much see what happens. Just fill out the paperwork. I'm sure that's... surely that's, you know, enough. But I don't know what happened. It's one way... I know, maybe. I mean, I was like... That would be the only benefit of this happening, is if I can, like, somehow seek refuge or like... Because you can't deport me. I quit America. don't call me Shirley. Because I don't know if you guys have heard, but they're, like, looking at... oh, donut damage. Welcome in. How are you? How's it going? How's your stream? How's the old Fortnite? And side note, everyone, I have to finish a thought, and it's going to be a very odd thought for all of you, and then I'll welcome you in. I was going to say, because I don't know if you guys have heard, but they're, like, talking about, deporting all, like, immigrants, including people who were, like, of immigrant parents who were born in the U.S., Hello. So I would go back to where they came from, ? I don't speak Spanish. So I'm like, I would try to go elsewhere. I'd shop around, I guess. So maybe because otherwise, if I'm just going to a country that I don't speak the language, that sounds like that's going to be a very bad deal for me. So maybe I can seek asylum somewhere else. But while you guys are thinking about that, let me welcome you all in with this nice little video. Hi Raiders, I'm Jet, your fourth favorite streamer. Yeah, fourth. You know, the guy you end up with when your favorites are offline and you misclicked my channel. Before we dive in, aw, Snapsicles, this is a family-friendly stream. Please keep your chats cozy and clean or my mods will be on you like a pack of wild pumas. Looking for a triple threat? Gaming, chatting, and looks? Well, let me tell you why I'm called Triple Jet. When it comes to gaming, we dive into puzzles, indie games, RPGs, and mysteries. But the biggest mystery of all will be why you're still watching. Like to chat? Well, we get so derailed it's like we're a train to nowhere and I'm your conductor. Choo choo. And when it comes to looks, I am like the solar eclipse, best not to look at. Now, if you want a good streamer, follow the creators I just linked in chat. They will obliterate my stream like a snap from Thanos. Mr. Bezos, I don't feel so good. But if you like the wonderfully wrecked vibe of a beat-up piñata, then you're in the right place. The candy's mostly gone, but we can still keep it sweet. So drop a follow and we'll make this siesta fiesta the absolute besta. Got a jet. So welcome in, everybody. Donut, how's your stream? I hope it was good. I hope you got some dubs. Did you get any dubs? Victoria Louise, welcome in. How are you? Gina, hello. How's it going? Wouldn't it be easier just to cross the border into Canada? Well, I think the point is they would send you to where your family is from. So my family's not from Canada, so I don't think they would do that. It all is dependent then if, like, Canada would open up their borders and stuff, but who knows? How are you, Thoughtful One? I'm doing good. I'm doing good. It's been a pretty weird couple of weeks, but overall, we're doing good. Today is a much better day. I don't know if you guys have realized we have not been follow-botted today, so excellent. But I hope you guys are all having a wonderful little day. Had a donut with Captain Crunch in it. I took physical donut damage. No! By the way, it has to be so late for where you are. One, donut damage and friends. If you need to lounge, lurk, etc., because it's late where you are, or this you just don't like it here, that's totally fair. Please make sure you take care of yourself. And Squego, thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate that, and I like your name. Dang, really? Yeah, that's some of the stuff that's going on here. Yeah, we've heard, but yeah, come to Australia. We like the nice people. And Ghosty Ghost, welcome in. Thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate it. So if that happens and they send me somewhere, I'm gonna try to. I don't know. I need to find a Australian consulate and be like, "Hello, I have friends. I have friends all across your country. Please take me. I don't speak Spanish." I was also just imagining how much of a nightmare that would be. Like, imagine if they just sent me to, like, you know, where my parents are from, and I don't, like, speak Spanish. Like, what am I gonna, like, what if, I speak very little Spanish. What would I do? Besides ask for where the library is. Nothing. So I would need to, you know, figure out a solution. So if I stop streaming, if ICE shows up, I'm not an illegal, by the way, but if ICE shows up and deports me in the middle of stream, you guys know what's happening. Because that would be me too. My dad wasn't born here either. I'm sure there's a lot of dependencies. I don't know. I honestly don't know how a lot of that works, but they're talking about basically, you know, deporting. Like, I assume it also has to be, like, generational. Like, I'm sure maybe after a few generations you're considered American. But they talked about they would like to get rid of, like, naturalized births. I think that's what it's called. Which is, if you are, like, even if someone is visiting the States, if they have a baby while they're here, the baby is considered American. So I don't know. I don't know. Technically, my family was living in England at the time. Like, when they had me, they were in England. They were then here for a bit, had me. They flew back, and then we moved back to the States. Where would I go? Would they send me to England? would they send me to where my parents are from? What would happen? Can I just request asylum in Australia? Is that a possibility? Can I get that started now? My family came here from Italy and Ireland. They're going to send 20% of me to each country. Oh, no. Oh, no. Get in the guillotine. But Gozzy, how are you? Welcome in. Are you also a big Fortnite player? No dubs, just funsies. That's, you know, that's all that matters. I don't speak Spanish, Jet. Siesta, fiesta. That, I mean, again, my Spanish is very limited. We're taking bids for Jet moving countries. Perfect. So the USA are copying the UK? Probably. To a degree. We'll see. And Squego. Oh, look at that little adorable doggo. Welcome in, Squego. How's it going? Aussie's open bidding at 14 Tim Tams. By the way, yesterday, Dez, I tried to see if, because we were talking about advent calendars, and I was like, actually, I've never really had one. I've had, like, a literal advent calendar that was, like, a calendar counting down the days till Christmas. But I haven't had one that had gifts or, like, little things inside. And I searched to see if they make a Tim Tams advent calendar, and they do not. And that seems to be... That's, you know, when I'm talking to, you know, the ambassador of Australia trying to request asylum. I'm going to bring that up to him. I'm gonna bring it up to them and say, you should really think about this. This is lost revenue. What if the country they are from doesn't exist anymore? I don't know. That would be a toughie. I don't know. We'll see. The U.S. has, we don't have to get super into it. The U.S. has some bad history with this type of stuff previously. This is not, like, the first time things like this have, like, really happened. Look up Japanese internment camps. So I don't know. We will see what happens. I don't know, don't know what they would consider, I don't know what we'd do, but say you're from the moon. free space flight. Perfect. Doesn't there need to be referendums to change your constitution so U.S. a born citizen is still protected? They're like, really pushing for it. I'm sure there'd be a lot to, there'd be a lot that would have to move. However, I think my understanding is correct. With the recent election and stuff, the people who would like that are in power in all spots that would, need to be in control. So we will see about that. I did hear that a lot of universities have already been sending their, so a lot of international students who come to the States for school are probably about to all leave to go back home for like Christmas and stuff. They have, a lot of universities have started to send notifications to their international students saying, by the way, if you plan to attend next semester, you should probably be back in the country before the inauguration of the next president, just to be safe. And so that seems wild to me. I'm not a big political person, so like I couldn't tell you all of the like ins and outs and everything, but it seems like there's a lot of people who would like this stuff to happen and would like to get rid of, people who have immigrated into the country, somewhat recently. Apparently they have tried in the past to get rid of like naturalized citizens or like by birth and whatever, but there's always been a lot of like pushback, but we'll see kind of what happens. But just something to think about. So if I'm like in Discord like, hey, by the way, there won't be any stream today, I'm being deported. You know why. And I will be, I don't know, I'll have to think of something. But I'll try to see if I can request Australia if they would allow me. I would imagine I would need like references. I'd have to like Daz, I'd have to like call you and YV and all of them and just be like, hey, I need some references. I need you guys to fight for me. That's how it works. I was born in Germany. I am German. So you're British. Well, come on over. Well, I'm not. So my family's from somewhere in the Latin America, South America. I don't know if I've ever said, so I'm kind of just being general. They moved to England at some point and then requested political asylum in the U.S. And so I don't know if that would be even considered. The fact that it was, they requested political asylum and they were granted that, I don't know if that, goes for or against me, really. So, but I was born in the U.S., before that, before they were requested or before they were granted political asylum. So I don't know. How does that all play out? I don't really know. It's a whole thing. But needless to say, if I can use this as a way to get to Australia and move there, excellent. Because I was looking at visas, and the process is daunting, and I don't know what I would even be applicable for. big brain. I saw this movie. Didn't it star Tom Hanks? I'm just in the terminal. I'm just gonna live at the airport. Gotta go as I have to be my little gremlin shadow. I hope you have an excellent day. It's just weird. They tried to force my mom to make it British. She was like, "Nah, I'm German, and we're in Germany." Fair. Missed opportunity to not have a Tim Tam advent calendar. I know. Imagine if it was like different types of Tim Tams for each day. Even if they're repeats, that would be excellent. Wherever you go, we'll give you more love than the U.S. sadly can. Probably true. Well, politics-wise. Yeah, fair. No, probably true, honestly. So, you're not wrong, Ghosty. I knew they were also pushing injecting yourselves with bleach, but at some point people said, no, that's a tad silly. Let's not do that. I mean, I wonder if anyone did. I don't know if people were injecting themselves with or was it an injection or was it consuming the horse stuff? What was that called? I don't even remember, but it was like a thing that like they thought like in minimal doses could help with like COVID, but then ivermectin. Yeah, that's what it is. But then people were like, just like, no, it's cheaper if you just get it from like an animal feed store. And so they were eating, like consuming like horse-made ivermectin or whatever. I saw this wonderful, do you guys remember Animorphs, the children's book? They had the covers where it's like, the like classic ones where it's like, where it's the kid and then it's like, each step is them like transforming into the animal. There was a hilarious when all this was coming out because I remember one of the main like pushers of ivermectin was Joe Rogan. There, someone put together like an Animorphs cover where it's him turning into a horse because of it, and it cracks me up. I think I have it saved on my phone somewhere because it was just so ridiculous. But anyway. Because this is the big issue we should be putting our resources into. Right. Yeah. Well, and that's the thing is like, that's also one of the things that's a little curious is because they're very much like, we need to deport all the immigrants. But like, that costs so much money. Like, from my understanding, when someone gets deported, it's like they also have to it can sometimes take like months for somebody to like legally be deported. In the meantime, you have to provide housing for that person and food while they're like in this like in between state. So like there's no way like. I feel like if they're going to do some kind of mass deportation, I don't know how they would do that. There's also, like, sometimes when someone gets deported, like, the country refuses to take them back. So there's, like, a lot of, you know, depending on, like, who the person is, if they're a criminal or whatever. Apparently France did that. And France and Algeria, I think, had some issues with that. They tried to deport a bunch of Algerians who were criminals. But then Algeria's like, we're not taking those people back. But then I think, like, to counteract that, France was like, okay, well then we're gonna, like, no longer allow any Algerian citizens to, like, go to school at any of, like, our France universities or whatever. So then I like, there was a lot of like that kind of stuff back and forth. So like to imagine them trying to like do this for a ton of people, logistically seems impossible. But they also just hate immigrants. So, like, I mean, I feel like they'll do whatever to get rid of people. So, well, and anyway, that's why a couple of there's some fear there of, like, well, if there's a lot of obstacles in the way, what else, would they look into doing? And, like, again, previously, back in, like, World War II, for those that don't know, if you're unawares, America, again, has some bad history, especially with the Japanese. They made, like, internment camps where they then sent Japanese people to live and whatever. Actually knew somebody who grew up in one of those. But so that would be wild. Would I stream from my internment camp? We will see. We will see if there is good internet. But anyway, maybe I'm going to try to go to Australia. If I can figure out a way. Can I preemptively do this? Can I, like, hit them up now and be like, by the way, I think I might get deported, but, here's my situation. Can I just go to Australia? Would you guys allow me in? Here are my references. Please talk to Stream and Daz. Just go to his, he's live. Just ask him about me in my chat, or in his chat. Deportation vlog stream? Yeah, just live vlog it. We'll vouch for you. Thank you, Daz. I've had many friends migrate to Aussieland. I feel like, I wonder how difficult it is for, well, I was looking at it. There's a lot of, like, contingencies. Like, you either have to be a student or you have to have, like, an employer vouch for you. Like, I need to be hired on by somebody. Do you need a butler, Daz? Do you need a butler? If you go as a student, you can only be in there, like, for as long as you're a student. If you want to just go there to work, you have to be under the age of 35. I am older than 35. So, whoops, missed my window. so, I don't know. Well, the white people should be deported as they were immigrants from England in the first place. But yeah, but they don't count, apparently. Obama signed the DACA bill, which gave protection to children of immigrants, but the new regime will likely get rid of all that. Yeah, they're definitely trying to do that. I mean, my dad was adopted 73 years ago, and we have very limited information about his mom. What we do know is that the area that she lived in was destroyed during World War II. Yeah, so I don't know. Indigenous people, you should push back and say, oh, wait, the indigenous people should push back and say, well, technically you're the immigrants. Yeah, I mean, I feel like they have before, but they won't listen. we can go back to eating Tide Pods. Wasn't life just more simple? Like, it seems much more simple back then. Yeah, ivermectin, yeah. Ketamine, no. It's horse dewormer, that's right, Jonzo. I totally forgot about that. I thought so, I just saw, starts with a K. Yeah, ivermectin. August 2021, the CDC issued a health alert prompted by a sharp rise in calls to poison control centers about ivermectin poisoning. So yeah, I guess people did die. Oh dear, yeah. For sure, people were absolutely on horse dewormer. Someone's DoorDash order got dropped off by mistake, and my cats eviscerated it. Oh no! Oh no! Oh, Jet, did you see the American troll dude that was being a nuisance to Japan and stuff? Went to Korea, got his passport confiscated. I did see that, and I feel like well deserved. I forget his name, but yes, well deserved. Yeah, he was doing, like, incredibly rude stuff over there. So, absolutely, for the sake of content, we love that. Ask them to send you the paperwork now. You'll probably need to rotate it as it'll appear upside down. So true. For those that don't, I mentioned this. This emote up here is actually right side up as to how I downloaded it. but apparently, if you go to Better TTV and look through their emotes, if you search for Australia, I was looking for Australia emotes, like that were related to Australia, but instead I found that there is just this like meme, I guess, where if you search for like an Australian emote, it's just a normal emote but upside down. And I think that is so funny. Anyway, Your mother's from Canada, right? Absolutely need a butler and a Ralph Bellies. Perfect. I will do that. If strike up the paperwork, I will I will sign it and I'll be over there ASAP. We'll get the Maori to visit America and help out. Get you started. Perfect. They can keep him. We don't want him. name not worth remembering. Yeah, no one's gonna claim him. I don't think. I don't know. That guy. Those types of content creators just make me so upset. I just can't stand how, like, especially going to another country and like causing ruckus and whatever. Like when I went to Japan, I felt like I know that I'm going to a country of like a completely different culture and like with a different set of expectations and all that sort of stuff. So like I tried not to stand out too much. Like I didn't try to, you know, I went there to like experience the culture. I didn't try to like bring attention to myself or like try to do stuff or I don't know. I feel like I'm very like play within the bounds of that they've given me and you know, all that stuff. So to imagine going to a place and being like, you know, publicly making fun of, you know, statues of significant meaning and then harassing people. I think the only thing that I did that was maybe I think would be considered like more of a faux pas is I took a lot of pictures in public and like of crowds and stuff. So I definitely got shots of people. I know in Japan they're a bit more private and don't like their photos, you know, taken or whatever. But I tried not to like, wasn't like singling people out. It was more of like wider shots or like if it was of somebody, it's like a zoom shot from far away. So I'm not like in their face or anything like that. So I think that's the only thing that I did that was probably more too touristy, but I'll accept Tim Tams as payment because I could still technically do my current jobs because I work remotely. I can still do my current jobs from Australia. So like that's not an issue. I could still have an income there even if I moved. Really, it's just, you know, the visa, like getting over there and having permission to, you know, stay there. And housing, really. That's pretty much it. Otherwise, I'd be kind of like, nothing would really change. And like, I would sell a bunch of stuff, but I would move like my iMac and, you know, probably some of my like equipment. That like that stuff would come with me. I could sell some of this. I could sell some of the lights and stuff. I'd take my PlayStation and like some of those electronics and bigger stuff. But like, I would sell a bunch of stuff. So I don't know. Anyway. I'll have to look more into that. Oh, I thought you were going to mention speaking Spanish. Oh, no. I didn't do that there. I did that at Disney World, but to a Japanese speaker. I need an Anzac Biki. They're so good. France sent me some homemade ones, but they have chocolate chips in them, so can't call them Anzac. But same flavor. That sounds delicious. Those are very, very good. I was actually thinking about them the other day. they're delicious. But yeah, Tim Tams, oof. Oof. So good. I was talking to YV and he had like a caramel one, maybe? I can't remember what it was. But he showed me a picture of it and he was like, I think it was a caramel Tim Tam. Be back soon? Alrighty. But it looked delicious, so I'm down for Tim Tam payment. But I'll have to look into that. Or, Daz, if you know anybody from the immigration office, let me know. Shoot me a DM. But anyway, besides all that, besides me potentially getting deported, how have you guys been? What else have you guys been up to? I did have sushi today. It was very good. I mentioned that earlier. Had that in just a side of rice, and it was so good. The one thing that was kind of weird, I guess, I wonder if this restaurant is like, they must be a big delivery restaurant, because when I got in there, I mean, it was like two, I think. Yeah, it's around two. So like after the evening rush, but I mean, not even the lunch rush, but, oh, let's see. Is my, okay. No, or my bit rate just kind of dropped a little bit. Oh, there was like nobody in there except for the one guy, like the chef. Like all the lights were off and he like never turned them on while I was there either. So it was just kind of like dark a little bit. I mean, they have like really big windows, so like lights coming in. So it wasn't like, I didn't feel, like I, you know, I didn't know. I knew they were open. They had a sign, but I was just like, I don't know. I was just a little bit like, oh, okay. I guess we're not gonna turn on the lights while I'm here. it's fine. Stand outside and call for delivery. I mean, no, they were definitely open. It was just like, okay. Lights are off. I also felt weird, even though I was like, I guess it makes sense. I sat somewhere and he never actually came to my table to take my order. And so I waited for a minute because I was like, should I go up back up to the, like he was in the little, so the setup. You walk into the door and you're like almost right at the like sushi bar, and like the kitchen. There's like a little cashier place, but then on the right it opens up and that's like where all the seating is. So I sat kind of in like the corner, back corner, and he just stayed kind of behind the like the sushi thing. And so when it was like, I was like, he hasn't come by to take my order, so I don't know what to do. And so I just kind of, I had the menu in my hand, so I was like, I'll just put the menu down, maybe that's the signal. But eventually he just looked over and he was like, do you know what you want? I was like, yes! But I was the only one there, but I was like, so I guess it doesn't matter if I'm like yelling my order across the room, but this feels weird. so I was like, yes! I'd like this sushi roll and some rice. He was like, okay. Like, all right. Caramel what? I think Wyvie had a caramel Tim Tam. Maybe it was caramel something? I don't remember exactly. But I don't remember. I'll have to ask him. He like sent me a picture of it. Those exist? Okay, maybe it was just caramel. I love caramel too, so that sounds very delicious. There are many different types of Tim Tams. You see, they should do an advent calendar. Like mint ones even? Perfect. It sounds delicious. Do they sell like a sampler? I when I get there, I would love like a sampler where I can try a whole bunch of different types. Or I'll just get all of them and I'll be like Scrooge McDuck, but instead of like a pool of gold, it's just a pool of Tim Tams that I can just swim through. Sample, we'll just hit Woolies and go buy a pack of each. Yeah, perfect. excellent, I'm done. Yeah, that works for me. But that would be so good. I loved like the original and the double coat. Those are both so good. Scrooge McJet. I love that. I love that. I've always wanted to do that, you know, like jump into a pool of money and swim, but, you know, they don't have those. Don't know if you guys realize, that's not really a thing. As far as I'm aware, original double coats are the best. That was so good. That was super, super nom nom. I actually even thought, I was like, I wonder, before I had the double coat, I was like, I bet I'll like the original more. But now, the double coat was delicious. You just need another friend mail sent your way, but each box is wrapped and numbered, so it's a surprise. Oh, I mean, I guess that's true. You could just do that. No. I did read that right. A friend mail. Friend mail threw me off, but yeah, I understand what you mean now. But each box is wrapped and numbered, so it's a surprise, which play really you'll be getting. That's true. It just feels weird that they don't sell it. Like, because, I mean, maybe they're afraid, like, it wouldn't travel well? I don't know. But, like, a lot of chocolate places have, you know, like, chocolate advent calendars. So you would think Tim Tams would be like, this is how we do it. The wife and I go out of our way to drive to World Market just to stock. Oh, do they have Tim Tams there? There is one place in town that I think might sell them, but I've never seen them before, but I don't go there that often. There is a international food market called New Sagaya here, and they sell a lot of, like, veggies that you wouldn't normally find at a normal supermarket. They sell... like, I don't know. I don't know if they would have Tim Tams. I know they have, like, occasionally, like, British candy. And they have, like, some, like, Asian, like, snack aisles. So, like, chips and, you know, that kind of stuff. They have, like, a little bit of candy. But I don't know what the chocolate situation looks like. I wonder if, does New Sagaya have a website? New Sagaya. They do. But can I search? Markets. Doesn't look like it. City Market, Midtown. I think the one I know is Midtown. Maybe I'll call them. Do you have Tim Tams? Can you order some if you don't? Wholesale. Can I just order wholesale, just pallets? A pallet of Tim Tams? World Market is where Mr. Payne and I go for, oh, Ramune. Oh, excellent. We don't have any World Markets here, unfortunately. I think I've been to one ever, and like just the one time. I know I've checked my like normal grocery store. They don't have them. They have some like random British stuff, but they don't have any Aussie stuff. So that makes me sad. Where would you store a pallet of candy? I don't know. I don't know. In my mouth. As they unload it, just like unhinge my jaw, just they just drop it in. That's why you'll get deported. Pallets of Tim Tams being delivered to your apartment. They're like, sir, we can't. This is actually unrelated to the whole political stuff. We just can't have this in your spare candy room. Yeah, exactly. You're just gonna start seeing like in frame like piles of Tim Tam containers. It's just, and they're like all unopened. It's just like, there's just no room. Kirby style, yeah. There's that hype train email. Consume. This is a front for something shady. Sassy, that's brilliant. The government will think Jed is Aussie. They'll ship him here. Oh, that's perfect. I need to work on my Aussie accent. Melbourne. I guess if I just say it not like Melbourne, maybe the U.S. won't know, you know? They're like, well, he didn't say it like Melbourne, so he must be Australian. Do you know anybody in immigration, Daz? Got any connections you can help me out with? Know the director? Is there a director of immigration? Surely. Who is in charge of immigration in Australia? A minister, right? The Minister for Immigration and Multicultural Affairs is a ministerial post of the Australian government and is currently held by Tony Burke. Do you know Tony Burke? I don't know immigration, no, but I know some lawyers that help out. Oh, excellent. And friends that did all that stuff. It is actually all good information. If you ever have any, like, you know, tips or something, send them my way. I have checked. There's actually, like, some moving to Australia, like, subreddits, I think, that I was taking a look at some stuff, but I don't know. We went to school together. Perfect. Perfect. The chances. What are the chances? Incredible. Such a small world. But yeah, I've looked at some of that stuff. I should probably, like, dig a little deeper. Maybe I should, like, pardon me now thinking about this, verbally processing all of this. Pardon me is like, maybe I should get ahead of this now. Like, should I actually, because if I wait, once it's all chaotic, it's gonna get wild real fast, you know? So maybe I should start getting ahead of this now. Like, maybe I should start saying, like, hey, just drop a line. I should drop a line at the immigration office for Australia and just be like, hey, it's me. Just wanted to say, you know, just want to see how you are. Just think about moving. I never catch a stream if you move to Australia. Well, that's not necessarily true, because I would still be doing work here in the States, so I would probably be waking up like normal time. I would just stream super early for me. Like, I would just stream in the morning, and it would be like, it's 11 a.m. over there. I could start 8 a.m. That would is typically the time that we normally start. Like, it would be fine. Yeah, just need to stream late morning over lunch. Yeah, perfect. Yeah, because, I mean, again, like, work-wise, not much would necessarily have to change. Again, I assume, depending on visa stuff, I might have to get, like, another job while over there. You know, it really wouldn't change. Yeah, stream then work. I mean, because my schedule is really flexible, so I don't see that being much of an issue at all. We'd get you here on a work visa. You can go do some design work or something at one of my old companies sponsored. Then you apply 6 to 12 months. Excellent. Daz, I'm down. I'm so down. I never catch a stream. Yeah. Yeah. I just need to stream early. Like Daz used to. Yeah, exactly. I really don't think it would change very much, because I also, like, I wouldn't want to stream while all of my other, like, Aussie friends are streaming, which they all stream at night, so I would do, like, daytime, probably, like, early morning, so. They also might melt, need to get one of those Mr. Freeze suits, but that would actually be hilarious. But, yeah, it would be, I mean, the weather would definitely be different, but I would be down to live somewhere where I, you know, had friends, I guess. So I'm willing to trade climate for friendship. So, I mean, if you need like a personal designer or something, you should start a company. Ralphie Incorporated, Ralph Inc. And then I'll be your designer. And I have to be, I have to, like, you know, I have to move there because, you know, in order to, like, really capture Ralphie's essence, you know, I have to be there. And then, well, I do run a business. I'm sure there's actually a lot that has to do with, like, sponsoring people. I'm sure, like, not any, I mean, well, I don't know, actually. I really know nothing. Yeah, I was going to say, how does, surely you have to, like, pay for something, right? Like, we'll raise the funds. Excellent. I mean, we're part of the way there. We have Aircon, it's all good. Wait, that should be a Hallmark card. I would trade climate for friendship. I love it. Business pays for sponsorship. Yeah, okay, that makes sense. Well, technically, you know, I mean, I am making money elsewhere. So I could technically feed it to you. I could technically pay you to help. Well, I guess, we don't know how much sponsorships are. Let's be real. Our friendship means so much to you. I'm willing to give up snow. Yeah, that's pretty nice. All right. Our friendship means so much to you. My friendship means so much to me. Your friendship means so much to me. I'm willing to give up snow for you. Yeah, I like that. That would be really nice. I mean, don't tell the other guy you meant that. Yeah, I guess that's fair. This is all private. This is off the record. You can't listen to this. They're not going to check the stream. Right? What was I going to say? We'll make it work. Lurk, I almost home for work. Gonna make some food and chill. All right, Gilmore. I hope you have a good one. But yeah, you know, I'll do some research. See how much a sponsorship is. Actually, you know what? Hold on. Let's Google. How much is a sponsorship? Citizenship sponsorship in Australia. How much do they have to pay? Wait. To become an approved sponsor under the TSS 482 visa program in Australia, the cost is currently $420. To become an approved sponsor. Ah, okay, wait, there's more to this. Nominating a visa applicant under TSS is $330. Actually, that seems pretty low. Baz, welcome in. How are you? Good morning from Brisbane, 11:55 in shower state. It has been raining over there a lot, hasn't it? I keep hearing storms, rain, etc., etc. Maybe it's legal fees. Maybe. Yeah, I guess. Yeah, you would think there'd be like some kind of large sum per person, you know? I don't know. I wonder, is that was probably Australian dollars too. So, I could help you with that. Yeah, storms every day. Yeesh. I need to put, I actually have a Brisbane clock on my desktop. I need to put, like, Brisbane weather on there just because I'm curious, like, how often it rains and stuff. By the way, it is currently, negative 10 Celsius here. It's pretty cold. Feel free to send some of that rain to New Jersey. We are lit. Oh, wait, really? Do you guys have fires right now? Negative 10, yeah. It's negative 10 Celsius, 13 Fahrenheit. It's fairly cold. It's fairly cold. I had to do some walking in order to go to the sushi place, and it was like, woo, it's windy. It's windy and cold. It's a bit brisk. I wore flannel, though. So I had a flannel, North Face zip-up, and a little down jacket. It looks very warm. Sassy's right. You very well may melt here. That's probably true. But again, you guys can just keep me in a little bucket or something. It's for the friendship. You'll probably die. I know. I've already been thinking about it. You don't have to worry. I will be what's the word? I'll be we're like dropping our bitrate and stuff randomly. That's strange. When I'm there, I'm gonna need to hydrate. I'm gonna need to like intentionally like stay hydrated. Miss Creative, welcome in. Wish I was up by you right now. I wanna do some ice fishing. Oh, that'd be fun. I've never done that before. I did see, I passed by a lake today. And I'm fairly positive it was fully frozen. I was like, 136, that's right, you guys. That was weird. Did that ever fix, that bug? There are approximately 1,200 wildfires across the state, and we've lost about 8,000 acres. What? That's wild. I haven't even heard anything about that. Also, apologies if our bitrate is cutting... dying or something. Keep an eye on that. If it fully dies, it will just probably stop stream. I thought this would be a short one. I don't know if we're actually even going to get into the game, really. I just called it part four in the case we do, but I figure because it was so late, it probably just ended up being just a chatting stream, but we can do Chicken Police tomorrow. But that sounds wild, Sassy. That's pretty crazy. But yeah, I'm a bucket of cold water. I might need it. I will definitely bring a water bottle and be trying to stay hydrated because I can't imagine how hot it's going to be and like how just the drastic change in temperature. I feel like that'll be wild. We'll be coming from I don't know when I'm going over there. I'm thinking about, it's definitely bitrate. What are you doing? Bitrate, are you okay? What's going on? Do I need to reset the router? We've gone 40 plus days without rain. We are desperate for some. Yeesh. Sounds like it. It's definitely been raining and snowy, you know, here, so. What was I gonna say? I was gonna say something. Something very important. I've lost it. I'm going to bring a water bottle. I'm going to have to like intentionally stay hydrated while I'm there because I feel like, yeah, it's going to be pretty wild, wildly hot. Oh, but I don't know when I'm going to be there. I've in my head had it like, it would be cool if I was there for y'all's winter. So like April-ish, April, May, something around there, but, we'll see. It all just, again, it kind of depends on the fundraising and all of that. See kind of what we get. I'm actually seeing, it looks like my bitrate is, yeah. Something's going wrong with my bitrate. I'm thinking, we'll maybe end here in like 10 minutes or something. Because I can't tell if it's going to stay stable. And we're dropping frames and stuff, so. It's been great for getting the kids outside, but the fires are bad. Almost constant smell of smoke. Oh, I hate that. We sometimes get forest fires here in Alaska, and that's rough. And yeah, well, it looks like my bitrate is like, it's kind of dying. I don't know if I need to like, bored of me, no! I'm gonna get off and start looking at visas. That's just what I'm gonna do. We just started so late. And again, now that my bitrate's doing a weird thing, I'm kind of like, maybe we should just end? Because I looked over at my iPad a couple times and I noticed it's like pausing and stuff. So so next week for Thanksgiving, I am going to get a pizza and eat it on stream. I'll get it the day before, but I'm going to warm it up for stream. But I did buy some potatoes today for some mashed potatoes. I think I'm going to make it like tonight or tomorrow. Even the bitrate is tired. Yeah. Yeah, it seems odd. We usually have a pretty strong connection, but it's, I've noticed that several times it's dropped into the red. So, and we in the past, like 15, 20 minutes, we've, dropped 2% of our frames. So it doesn't seem like a lot, but it's enough that it's like, it should be zero. So, or very, very low for me to be happy, but I don't know. I see it bouncing a little bit. Oh, we're done with this playlist. Boop. There you go. But tomorrow we can continue Chicken Police. And we'll keep doing that. Then we'll do Rise of the Golden Idol. Again, I still need to hit up YV to see if he wants to do a special thing either this Friday or next Friday. So I don't know when that'll be, but I'll let you guys know. And then I need to figure out what we're going to play on Thanksgiving. I don't really know. I don't know what the plan will be. I have to look at what games we have. But I think for most of the month of December, I think we're going to be playing Zelda. That's going to be my plan. And then we'll see. I'm sure we'll throw in some indie games into the mix, but play all the things. So many things. And I mean, we have a few different like indie games that I could play, but I don't know what we'll do for Thanksgiving. Are there any turkey games? I'm sure there are. I don't know if they're good. I don't know if they're good games. I have not heard of a like well-known good turkey game, so not to say that there isn't, but I am unawares of them. That makes it even more fun, would it? I have to choose stuff that you guys will watch also, you know? That that's also the you know, the issue at hand. And I have some games. I have some games that I've been like sitting on that what if we did a you know, we could do a
is this a murder?
We need one of those really bad hidden object games about Thanksgiving. Is there one? Oh, actually, there probably is. I think about it. You met a South Park game for the N64 had turkeys. Oh boy, I bet they did. I was gonna say, what if we did a an FMV game? Because most of those are like kind of short enough that we could maybe do it in one sitting, maybe. And they're kind of weird and special enough. Jackbox. Well, I don't know. So I don't know who's gonna be around for Thanksgiving, Daz. That's the thing. I'm really mostly counting on the Aussies maybe being around. when is Thanksgiving? It's next Thursday. So I know like a lot of the Americans will be gone, but I know some of you guys have said that you'll pop in after you know your Thanksgiving meals and stuff, but you know, usually you guys might get like pulled away. You might be watching the big game. Isn't there usually a Thanksgiving game? I feel like there's a game on Thanksgiving usually. I guess I'll be watching. Oh, yeah, my bitrate is dropping. You know, you guys might be watching the big game, or maybe I don't know, you're doing family stuff, getting Christmas set up. Go sports ball. maybe you're getting Christmas stuff set up. I know that's a lot of people, you know, or you're getting ready for Black Friday, ready to stomp on people, while going for like very mediocre deals. Maybe that's what you're doing. So like, I don't know. And Baz with the 30 stream streak. Incredible, Baz. You're crushing it. Thank you so much. I literally could care less about the sports ball. So maybe we'll do it. I mean, that'd be kind of fun to do an FMV game. I have a few of those that we've been sitting on for a bit. I'll take a look. I'll think about what we're doing. I lost mine somewhere. No, it's okay. It's totally great. We love a 7 stream streak. Thank you so much, Daz. I appreciate any streak at all. And even if you don't have one, I appreciate you as well. I just appreciate people sticking around and watching and being here, so. You guys are great. I know I already have a couple, like, well, let me look at my games. I wish I could just search for it, like, FMV. We have, by name. I have some that I know are longer. We won't do those. We did Contradiction. Her Story, I have heard really good things about. I don't know how long that is. Dragon's Lair? Oh, that old game? Okay. Is that really difficult? Isn't it? I feel like I've heard that's a very full motion video. I think that's what it stands for, yeah. How long to beat? I'm thinking of like, it's where it's like a, it's fully like recorded. Like they have actors in place, but it's usually like a point and click or some kind of mystery. We've played two so far. One was Contradiction, which was really good. And I've heard Dragon's Lair is very unforgiving. Yeah, it sounds like it. Thanksgiving Day Griddlers. Oh boy. You see, the thing is, I hate, well, actually, these are somewhat themed, but I don't know. I don't think you guys would be interested in watching me do that. I think you guys get bored very fast. Thanksgiving themed Picross, I do like that. I like the idea of it. Some SWAT games were FMV. SWAT. I don't know if I've played those. I do recommend Contradiction. It was weird, but good. And then we played the Infectious Madness of Dr. Decker. And that was very fun. It was very difficult, though, because the way it works is you are a, like, you're taking the place of a psychologist. He has been murdered, and you're having to interview all of his patients to see if any of them know what happened to him. And all of his patients are really weird. And so it's like kind of spooky a little bit. And but what makes it difficult is the way you play the game is you have to ask questions. Like you type out questions. And the game then processes that. And like if you type in the right keywords, it'll unlock a new little video where that patient is then answering your question. But it was just very difficult because you'd have to be very specific with the question asking. I'm just trying to find the most random ones I can find. I loved all the Police Quest games. Hold on. Police Quest SWAT. Oh, interesting. I don't think I've ever seen this before. Yeah, so kind of similar to, yeah, I've never seen that. That's wild. Those cutscenes look hilarious and dated. Her Story is apparently only 3.5 hours, and I have heard good things about it. So maybe Her Story would be good. Very positive. A woman is interviewed 7 times by the police. Search the video database and explore hundreds of authentic clips to discover her story in this groundbreaking and award-winning narrative game. I'm not that old. No, but I mean, like, the you can tell, like, the graphics are, like, super pixelated and all that, like, even in the video. That's what I mean. So her story could be an option. It's going to be, like, it'd be hilarious if, like, the topic of her story is just so intense, like, it's terrible for Thanksgiving. we've got her story. What else? The Dark Side of the Moon. That has the same guy from Contradiction. How long is that? Dark Side of the Moon. That is apparently 3.5 hours. The Shape-Shifting Detective also has a detective guy. What was it? Shape-Shifting Detective. 4 hours. Okay, so actually a lot of these could be an option. That's good. Maybe we'll do... Her story sounds interesting to me. And it has the best reviews. So maybe. Which was the Alien plus Water one? Alien plus Water. What kind of game was it? Alien plus Water. I'm not sure. Not 100% sure what that could be. Do you have any more to go off of? Motion video thing, but like old days, DOS. DOS Alien Water Game. Alien River? Deadly Tide? Alien Legacy? Not really, I don't know. Maybe if I also put FMV? Alien Logic? Alien Virus? I like how a lot of, you can tell like what era game is from, because it's just like there wasn't any other like options, so they just keep throwing like alien something, like it you know, they didn't have to be that creative with the names. Maybe we'll play her story. What's the okay, it would definitely be a Jet After Dark based on the mature content description. Just so we know. I'll have to let you guys know. XCOM Terror from the Deep. Unstable Balance, how's it going? Huh. Perfect. The very first thing on the list on the Steam page is, like, intense. So we'll... Tav, welcome in, Tav. How are you? How's it going? We're probably gonna be ending stream very soon. My bitrate seems to be dropping a little bit. Plus I started kind of late, so. Goes here. Better though, we have not gotten a single follow bot attack today. Just FYI, everybody, if you're keeping count at home. The count is 0. So we love that for ourselves. that makes the day better. How are you doing? Don't say that out loud. I know I'm jinxing myself. It's gonna come in. Yeah, I know. No, it's my bad. I always like to call those things out, and then people are like, "No, don't say that." I'm like, I'm sorry. I just wanted to point it out. How are you, Tap? But yeah, we haven't played an FMV game in a while, so maybe Thanksgiving Day, that might be a good time for it. Cause that way, like, if stream is entirely dead that day, it's fine. Like, I'll have, you know, that, or I don't know, we'll see what happens. I don't know if we'll do anything else Thanksgiving-y. And yeah, we'll probably end stream in like 5 minutes. I just snoozed ads for the last time, just so that you guys don't have to sit through ads and then me be like, okay, well, bye. Good, exactly packing for tomorrow. I'm leaving work early tomorrow to go to Manchester Orchestra concert. So I'm packing to stay the night at the family's after the show. That's so wonderful, Tap. I hope you have an absolute blast. I have heard of some of their music, or like I've listened to some of it, and I really like it. So I hope it's a fun concert. But that's super, super fun. I hope it is just a blast. I'm pumped. By the way, Tap, in December, I'm gonna start up Tears of the Kingdom. So I'm going to be on your tail. finally trying to see if I can catch up to you. So I'm going to laugh when you lap me. That's going to be funny. We'll see. We'll see. It'll be like Tears of the Kingdom releases and then I'm 200 hours in, so I'd say about halfway. Oh my gosh. I don't know. I don't know if I have that in me to play Tears of the Kingdom for 200 hours. I need to figure out how long I played Breath of the Wild. I'm working on a Tears of the Kingdom painting right now, actually. Ooh, what's it of? Tap is 200 hours in to TOTK. I don't even know if it'll show up in my recently played, because I have not recently played it. Oh no, it does, because I remember checking. It's like, I'm 25 hours in. Yeah. 25 hours in. Oh, no, Breath of the Wild, that's what I wanted to check. Is not on here. Is there any way you can, like... Like, if I select a game in my library? Where are you? Breath of the Wild? Hello? Don't they keep the icon even if... Yeah, they do. Where's my copy of Breath of the Wild? No, that's Tears of the Kingdom. Hello? Starting from the bottom? It's not here. Well, never mind. I guess we'll never know. I don't know how many hours I have in it. Actually, it would be weird, too, because I think I already played a bunch of it before, so yeah, it wouldn't be accurate. Anyway. Really gotta start on lunch now. Thanks for the hangs. If you're gone before I get back, be everyone. Yeah, we'll be gone here pretty shortly, but Daz, I hope you have a good one. Have a great day. But it's from a certain scene, so I need to check which one so I can... Oh, fair. Okay, I won't look at it. I turn into a nonsensical gremlin when I play that game. I have watched a bit of it when it looks non-spoilery, and it does seem very fun to watch you play it. I failed my chat GPT search. Ah, it's okay. We'll figure out that name of that game eventually. But I hope you have a good one, Daz. It's fun to watch you solve different puzzles and stuff with some of the, like, mechanics that you can, like, build stuff with. It's very fun. I'll have to remember, like, where I left off. I mean, I guess luckily we have VODs, so I can double check. I think I remember I was trying to get all the towers, but I don't remember, like, story-wise really where we left off. I think we last talked to Impa at some point. I'll let you know if you've seen it already. Okay, fair. Well, friends, I think we'll go ahead and stop here because, it looks like it's cool that I can actually watch you play now. It's true. You'll actually be able to see the beginning. still so early on. I had to avoid it first, but now I can tag along for a bit until you lap me. No, I totally get that. I do the same with people playing any game that I'm, you know, interested in or whatever. So you're totally good. But yeah, we'll go ahead and end, or you start from the beginning. Honestly, we're not like that far ahead that would be impossible, but let's just move on where we left off from. So yeah, friends, we'll go ahead and stop here. Again, my bitrate actually just dropped again, but yeah, maybe I'll make sure I've refreshed the, restart my router tonight or something. But we'll be back tomorrow. We'll actually play some Chicken Police, and we'll lounge and we'll hang. But you've unlocked a bunch of the map already. So starting over, yeah, it would be a lot. But story progression wise, we've gotten like nowhere. So that wouldn't be that bad. Anyway, ads have started, so I apologize for people who have ads. But we'll go ahead and stop here. But friends, thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much, Angelic Wanderer, for the resub for 10 months. I very much appreciate it. Amers for the 90 stream streak. Donut Damage for the raid. Squego and Ghosty Ghost for the follows. Baz for the 30 stream streak. And Daz for the 7 stream streak. There's no reason to start over. You do have, yeah. It'll be fine. But friends, thank you so much for hanging out with me today. I very much appreciate it. Oh, I think yesterday, while I was reading the thank yous, I think I forgot to say thank you to Wyvie for resubbing. I don't think he was on the list, but after a stream, I was like, wait a minute. I was like, Wyvie resub. Good timing, as I have to head off myself. Sleep is imminent. Friends, thank you again. Very much appreciate all of you. Thanks for popping in for this short stream. But I hope you guys have a wonderful day. We'll be back with more Chicken Police tomorrow. So I will see you guys then. Bye-bye!